organisms have the ability to detect change in their environment, which is called sensitivity, while the change that stimulates the response is known as stimulus. The stimulus is divided into external and internal stimulus. Mammals can detect stimulus through a receptor. The stimulus will convert to a nerve impulse and it will send to the brain through the nerve cell. The brain will translate the nerve impulse and coordinate an appropriate response. Response refers to the way organism react after detected stimulus, which is called the effector. Coordination is a stimulus to ensure that the overall activities and system organism are synchronized perfectly.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Arif Sakini, member of Hafiz. So today I'm going to present to you about type of receptors and the necessity of response. So sensory receptors are found at the end of the nerve fibers to detect information in the external and internal environments. The location of receptors will depend on the type of stimulus. So for example, the sensory receptors that detect external stimuli are found in eyes, nose, tongue, and skin. The sensory receptors that detect any internal stimuli are present in specific internal organs, as the pancreatic cells that detect blood sugar level. So now I will tell you about the types of sensory receptors and the stimulus involved. So for photoreceptor, the stimulus involved is light. Thermoreceptor is change in temperature. Chemoreceptor is the change in chemical substance. Baroreceptor is change in pressure. Mechanoreceptor is touch and pressure. And nociceptor is pain. So the necessity of response. Why is response important? So first, so the ability of organism to detect changes in the external environment and its response to its stimuli is very important for the survival of organisms. For some animals, a sudden change in climate condition motivates the animal to look for new shelters. The ability of organism to detect changes in the internal environment is also crucial so that the information can be transmitted to the integration center. So in conclusion, humans and animals need to respond to adapt to the changes of internal environment.
Hello everyone, my name is Nick M. Shafiq bin Azlin, and today I will present chapter 12.2, which is nervous system. So human nervous system is made up of network of nerve cells, which is central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. So central nervous system consists of brain and spinal cord, and the peripheral nervous system consists of 12 pairs of cranial nerve and 31 pairs of spinal cord. Brain is the coordination and the control center for human. The main component of brain is cerebrum. Is the largest structure in frontal part of brain. It is also a center that controls emotion, hearing, sight and personality. It also responsible for higher mental abilities such as learning. Cerebellum maintain body balance and coordination of muscle contraction for body movement. Hypothalamus, coordinating homeostasis, control center that regulate body temperature, connect nervous system to the endocrine system. Pituitary gland, located at the base of hypothalamus,
the main gland in endocrine system secrete hormone that controls secretion of hormone. Lastly, medulla oblongata, located at anterior of the cerebellum, control involuntary actions such as heartbeat and breathing.
So the spinal cord is contained with the vertebral column and is surrounded by cerebrospinal fluid that protect and supply the spinal cord with nutrients. The spinal nerve extends from the spinal cord through two short branches or root, which is dorsal root and ventral root.
Dorsal root contain the axon of the sensory neuron that send impulse from sensory receptor to spinal cord. Ventral root contain the motor neuron that send nerve impulse from the spinal cord to effector.
The function of the spinal cord is
process few type of sensory information and send response, control reflex action, and connect brain with peripheral nervous system.
So the peripheral nervous system consists of somatic nervous system and autonomic nervous system. The somatic nervous system regulate the control activity, while the autonomic nervous system control the involuntary action such as heartbeat and the contraction of the blood vessel. The function of the peripheral nervous system is to connect sensory receptor and effector to the central nervous system. That's all from me, thank you.